Hey Gemini, I'm Zia Patsy. I'm going to be doing your love bite for mid-February to mid-March. Well, the end of February to the end of March, okay? Basically, till I get to you again. Okay? But it'll be around the middle of March, okay, or after. So, I'm going to do a regular love bite for you. We got five cards for you, five cards for your partner, all right? And then we got some cards from the Conscious Spirit Oracle, and then we got two cards from a new deck that I'm using, the Cycle Journey of Love, and that's by Alana Fairchild Rosulli and Richard Cohn, all right? And it is published by Blue Angel Books, all right? And you can go online and look at some of the prints of these beautiful cards that they have. And I think that you can order prints online if there are cards that you like to have just as, you know, artwork in your home, because they are works of art. Okay, so first card in your reading here was chemistry. There's a strong magnetic attraction here. Okay, and this is you. These are your cards, your first set. Trust. Situation is calling on you to have faith. So you have chemistry with someone and you're trying to have faith and trust that this is going to work out. Forgiving and learning. As you release and heal the past, you experience more love in your present moments. All right, so you're trying to release your inhibitions, your the things that are haunting you, the things that have made you frightened, the things that have frightened you, yes. And you're trying to release them so that you can be open to new experiences and love. And you trust this person with that information. Express your love. Go ahead and make the romantic gesture. But this is in reverse. So it seems that someone's holding back or you're holding back on expressing your love, or you feel that your partner's holding back. Okay, so you feel like you've been open and giving, and you feel like your partner isn't reciprocating in that manner, as far as opening up, talking. The next card says, let go of control issues. Let them reach that point when they're comfortable with it, the same way you do. You didn't live their life, you don't know what's going on, what's bothering them, what their issues are. So the best way to handle that is to just pray for them. I know it's frustrating because when you want to be able to exchange information, you want to, as you're learning, as you're growing and trying to learn and forgive and get to know each other, you like to get what you're giving, you want that back. Some people just aren't there yet. That doesn't mean that they don't love you. It just means that there's other things going on that are far beyond what's happening right now. And they don't even want to bring it up. They don't even want to think about it. They don't even want to bring that into their place with you, because right now they may be feeling in a happy place when they talk to you. And if they bring up those things, it might take them to a place that they don't want to be. So maybe this is about having some compassion and empathy, even if you don't understand why and what's at the root of it. Just be mindful to keep that thought that I just shared with you. Maybe it's that it's too ugly. Maybe they haven't even faced it yet. Maybe they don't even know what the truth is. They may know something, but maybe it's so deep inside of them they don't remember enough to share. And when they're with you, they want to have a happy time. Okay, so thank you for joining me today. And let's see if we can see what's going on with them. Okay, so these five cards here are for your partner. First card is make the effort. Great love is worth taking the steps you're guided to take. So, they're willing to make the effort, or maybe they want you to make more of an effort, or they're trying to make an effort, but it's hard, like I said. It's hard for them to do that because it's deep stuff that they don't ever talk about, that they probably have never talked about with someone else either. Imagine that. Something that no one knows but them. Or no one knows about them. No one that they know or that they hang around. They don't know that. Next card is engagement. So this is talking about them wanting to commit to the relationship further. You know, they like to increase the amount of time that you all get to spend together. They want you to trust them and have faith in them. And they want to have faith in the situation. They're trying very hard to make the effort, but there's something that's blocking. Next card for them is very soon. Clearly decide what you want so that it comes to you now. And that fell under forgiving and learning for you. I looked at this card earlier. This looks like just a very gentle interaction between two people who really love each other. It just says gentle. And I think that that's what it's telling me to say, that you have to be gentle with this person. Or you need to be gentle with yourself, Gemini. But you have to learn how to trust. You have to open up. And even if you haven't told everything that you should tell or everything that you need to say, say that. Just say that. Maybe that would be enough to say, okay. But it has to come from you. They don't want to have to pull it out of you. Very. This could be the one. That's the next card that came up for your partner. You've already met the romantic partner you seek. So, that fell under express yourself. This person wants to, you want your partner to express themselves. They want to get to know you. They know that this is something special. They're just being hesitant. They're a procrastinator also, true. They're very definitely a procrastinator, but it's less about just being a procrastinator and just trying to juggle or anything, and more about trust. Last card for your partner was children. Your love life is being affected by children. So either you have children, your partner has children, or someone's acting childish, or it fell under let go of control issues. Maybe this blockage, this hurt, this thing that you're partner is looking at or holding on to, not relaying to you, has to do with childhood issues for them that are very deep-seated, and that may take a professional help to help, you know, expose and explore it or whatever. But if not, it's going to take a lot of trust, because it just may be something that they feel are better left unsaid. I just got a ding. I don't know where that ding came from. I think that was a confirmation. Something just went ding. Okay. Yeah. Maybe some things are better left unsaid. You don't need to know everything. All you need to know is that you're going to accept this person unconditionally, whether they tell you these stories, these episodes, these experiences or not. This is about unconditional love. And if later on they decide that they want to tell you, you have to be sure that you are going to be able to accept whatever they tell you that they did. Whatever they tell you that they've done, or that they've thought about, or that happened to them, or whatever this thing is, whatever this blockage is. And you have to think to yourself, what could they tell you that you would not accept? Is there anything? Is it truly unconditional love? Or does it have a condition at the end? It might just be one condition, but it's not unconditional. That's hard. It really is. It's hard. It's hard. But that's part of the journey, I guess, to come up against those hard truths, those hard decisions. And if there is something that you can't accept, then maybe you could just say what it is that you won't accept. And ask them to be honest with you. And maybe go about it that way. Or leave it alone. So next, I got some cards from the Conscious Spirit Oracle. First card, Spirit Awakens. I embrace my soul purpose and align all aspects of my soul to it fully. And that came between make the effort and chemistry. So, this is something I think that is meant to be, okay? Spiritual awakening, chemistry, make the effort, yeah. God is speaking. This is divine timing, this situation that you may be experiencing now, Gemini. Oh, and you're getting a reward anyway, right? Didn't you get a cosmic completion, karmic completion recently? So yeah, maybe this is God giving you this gift of this person who you have chemistry with, who is trying to make, who wants to make the effort to bring you great love. Next card that came here was Sun Goddess. This is a new phase, a new day, something bright coming your way, something comforting and warm, someone comforting and warm. And they've had their dark clouds, their dark moments also, but they're being led by their ancestors to you. And you just need to have faith and trust. Your love is ascending to a higher level of commitment. This is something that's divine. This is a divine relationship. Next card that came up from the Conscious Spirit Oracle by Kim Dwyer was Forest Frolic Maiden. I acknowledge my inner child and open my heart to the joy she brings. But this is in the reverse. So again, we're talking about things. This fell under forgiving and learning, and very soon. These are about childhood issues for yourself and your partner. And both of you. Both of you have some work to do, but I think that the intention is for you all to do this work together, because I think that you're going to have somebody that's going to be able to support both of you through these touchstones, you know, like when you get to this thing that has to be confronted or addressed or whatever, you're gonna need a team. You're gonna need backup. And the backup is gonna be the person that loves you more than anything and trusts you. And you trust your best friend, your lover, your spouse, your partner. The ride or die. So all the other things that you've been dealing with over the years and time, that was good. You could do that. And you did it. And you got there. Karma completion, right? Now this phase is someone to help you ride out the rest of the ways. This could be the one. That fell under express your love, right? Under reverse. This could be the one. Now from the journey to love card, right? These are the back of those cards. It was 3 to 1. I'm gonna hold that so you can see how beautiful this card is. Just absolutely gorgeous. It says 3 to 1. It looks like a family there. A mother, a father, and a baby. And looks also like some people watching from behind. From behind the mountains, the top of the mountains. Way back. Let's see what this says. 3 to 1. And this is card number 10. Okay? So 10 is about individuality, right? 10 is about the end of a cycle. Okay, here we go. Could you cut that light off for me? Okay. 3 to 1. There is a heavenly child in your midst. It may be within your heart or in your womb or a glimmer in your eye, soon to be. This child holds the key to the fulfillment of a process that's happening for you right now. The child may be a physical culmination of your marriage or commitment to another. It might be a symbolic birthing of a new self after a time of learning to bring male energies of protection and discernment together with female energies of feeling and creativity, whether within yourself or within your relationship with another. The child might symbolically be a new life, an improved relationship, a book, a new job, a completely renewed way of dealing with what was once a challenging issue and so soon will not be an issue for you anymore. Just to name some examples, from masculine to feminine to child, there is now just one, a new reality dawning with grace. This oracle holds a message for you. New life is upon you now. You are being reborn, and you will give birth to what is meant for you in this lifetime. There's no need to worry. Just pray with an open heart that you may be supported to fulfill your destiny. You already are, of course, but prayer can help you realize it. The rest is in the loving and capable hands of the divine. Now there's a poem that goes with this, right? 3 to 1. Love is what makes the heart beat faster. The lump in my throat. The feeling of missing you so much that I can't wait to be with you again. And then we are. And I look in your eyes deeper and I know the unspoken words that I say the unspoken words that say I love you and feel words in return. The unspoken words that say I love you and feel words in return. How short each lifetime seems, but what I feel with you lasts forever. May love be the compass that guides you on the course of a lifetime. So there's a new beginning coming your way, right? Spirit has awakened. Sun goddess, a new day. But you won't be by yourself. You know, they say, you know, you come in the world by yourself, you leave by yourself. But this time you're going to come in the world with a partner. Somebody that's going to come through this with you. Someone to travel with you. And then you got another card from that same deck, Journey of Love, Heaven. Heaven. Can you see it? Can you see Heaven? That's the last card in the book. You're meant to live in heaven now, not later, sometime after you die. What use is this life and body if not to live in heaven now? Look for the mad genius in all. That is especially the puzzling parts of your life that make you scratch your head or tear at your hair or scrunch your face and scream of frustration. Those are the places in which the divine is saying, here heaven is hiding. Let's unveil it together. Let me show you. Let me unveil your own mad divine genius right here. Look for heaven. Even in hiding, it will not withhold itself from you for long. It wants to be known by you, beloved. This oracle brings you a special message. The Enlightener is calling you to more and more and more. To more divinity, more love, more acceptance, more embrace of life itself. There is no limit in what is being offered to you from the divine lover calling you. Rejoice and know that the dance of love between you and the divine is removing veils of illusion, one at a time. Until you behold one another naked and true, finally to discover you are each other. You are love. The sky ablaze with morning light on silver wings of bird in flight. In gratitude, a tear released, a knowingness embraced at peace. She speaks to those that gaze below, ancestral wings which call my soul to open hearts and soar above in awe of wind. Await this love. Beautiful. I think they want you to let go of your control issues and know that there's something that is coming your way. Something fabulous, something that you prayed for, something that you've manifested, and something that you deserve, and that the divine wants you to have. And you just got to get out of your own way. Let go of control issues. This is not a codependent relationship. Because whether that you do this together or not, there are things that you all may have to tackle on your own that you can still do. But I think that it would have been wonderful for you to have done this together. But that's up to you. That's free choice, right? Free will. So, let's see if we can get something from the numerology deck by Michelle Bachman. Thank you very much. Health, 71. 71 is 8, so this is about the divine. This is a message from the divine. 71, health. This card indicates the need to focus on yourself. Care and well-being. By drawing this card, you're being encouraged to explore practices and behaviors that can enhance your physical, emotional, and mental health. When you explore conventional, whether you explore conventional or alternative methods, it's important at this time to put your health and happiness first. This is a time to eliminate any unhealthy habits and behaviors are impeding your success. You can seek professional assistance if you need to, or make improvements on your own. Some of the basic necessities for optimal health are regular checkups, good nutrition, exercise, plenty of water, getting a good night's sleep, detoxification, going outside in nature, engaging in relaxing activities, avoiding toxic people and environments, maintaining a positive mindset, meditation or yoga, defining your own personal limits and boundaries, doing what you love, laughing often, and spending quiet time alone. In order to improve your current situation, you're being asked to and adjust to and harmonize with the natural systems and rhythms and cycles of your life. Cycles that are encouraging you to work on improving your current state of health. This isn't time to procrastinate. You are being called to take action. Call upon your spirit guide and angels if necessary to be shown in the next step, to be shown the next step to take for the sake of your health. The affirmation is, with a healthy body and mind, I raise my energy vibration. Ashe. Ashe. Wonderful. Beautiful. Okay, Gemini, I'm liking that. And that's so funny, is you heard all that noise that was going on through the beginning of the reading. My son came in, and I had ordered one of those all-in-one gems off of QVC, and it just came. See? I have an intention. So, that's funny that came up. So, take a step. Let's get healthy, folks. All right, drink a lot of water, and let's start walking. Let's start moving. All right, then. So, see, got another ding. Okay, let's see if we can get anything else from the Yana Van Zandt Until Today cards in reference to your situation. So this is for Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. From the end of February to the end of March, right? I cannot fail in life, and life cannot fail me. Amen. Ashe. Until today, you may have been sitting around, afraid to move and afraid to fail. Just for today, be devoted to seeing yourself and your life as a function of spiritual truth. Remind yourself that you cannot fail. You are supported by life, which knows that your success is assured. Very nice. Let go of the control issues. Work with your partner. because whatever it is that's bothering them or whatever they haven't been able to share with you, they will in time. And if they don't, accept that. Accept that. But that's not going to happen. But they have to be able to trust you. And it might take a while. That may be part of the thing that's causing them not to trust. Okay. Get professional help if you need it. Go with them and pray for them. And ask your ancestors to help them. And if you're married to them, you can even talk to their ancestors. Because they're your ancestors because you're married. You can petition them and just let them know that you'd like their help. And you have to ask them to intercede. Your ancestors, their ancestors, they're not going to do anything unless somebody asks to help for the help. They're watching. But this is part of the lesson. You have to learn how to contact the divine. You have to learn how to ask for help. That's part of learning about faith and trust. But you have to ask for the help because we were given a free will. But this is going to work out. You'll be fine. Just work on our health. Spring is sprung. Almost. Okay? So I will be seeing you guys in the beginning of March as I start to do the general readings. All right? Take care of yourselves. I love you. Congratulations. Things look like things are coming along swimmingly for you. Heaven awaits, Gemini. Talk to you soon. Ashe. Peace.